Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and happy Valentine's Day. I am Chris Nordyke, the Vice President of External Affairs here at the Richard Nixon Foundation, and I'm delighted to welcome you and some special guests to tonight's event. Those special guests are the WOW group from Cavalry Chapel, Chino Hills. This group right here. Thank you guys for being here. I was told the acronym stands for Women of Wonder. Also with us tonight is the civilian aide to the Secretary of the Army, Bridget Blim. Bridget, will you please stand and be recognized? Thank you for being here, Bridget. And Colonel Jason Clark, who's the garrison commander at Fort Irwin. Colonel. Thank you all for coming and showing your support tonight. Valentine's Day at the Nixon Library is always a special day, and we do indeed have a special program that will begin in a few moments. But while I have your ears, I'd like to bring your attention to the postcard on your seats. The backside notes some great upcoming events that I hope to see each of you at. We have Speaker and Ambassador Gingrich. We have the White House Historical Association unveiling the official 2022 White House Christmas tree ornament, which is pretty spectacular. We will celebrate First Lady Pat Nixon's 110th birthday. And then there's one in particular that I'm very excited to be a part of, and the foundation is very excited to host. And that's the launch of a great new book titled The President's Man, whose author is a gentleman named Dwight Chapin. And Dwight was one of Richard Nixon's most trusted advisors and is a real inspiration. Dwight was an advanced man in the Nixon White House. Got a start at a very young age, 21 years old, and was at the president's side for decades. He was there for Richard Nixon's 1962, you won't have Nixon to kick around anymore, gubernatorial press conference. He was there for Watergate. He was there for the world-changing trips to China, the Middle East, the Soviet Union, and he was there for Nixon's election to the highest office in the land. He was there when Nixon spoke to the men on the moon. Dwight was there for Richard Nixon's highest of highs and his lowest of lows, and he's going to be here this Thursday at an event in this very room to tell the entire story. The event is free, so you have no excuse not to return to the Nixon Library. The event is free, but you do need to register. You can do it on the information that's on that postcard. Take that thing home, put it on your refrigerator, think about us. But if you don't put it on your fridge, be sure to just check us out online, nixonfoundation.org, and you can follow the exciting events and happenings that go on here in this East Room. This is an exact replica of the White House East Room. This is America's grand ballroom that you are sitting in tonight. And you'll get to see exciting happenings, much like tonight's celebration of Valentine's Day. And Valentine's Day is a very special program and special day for us every year. It gives all of us, including myself in particular right now, the opportunity to celebrate the ones we love. Gives us the opportunity to show gratitude for the special bond that has had and the appreciation for what true love can accomplish. And tonight, it gives us a special way to share the love of this great country, the United States of America. And each year here at the library, myself and the others on staff can't help but think about the love between Richard Nixon and Pat Nixon. Over the course of 53 years, the Nixons enjoyed a long and happy marriage. Through all of the ups and downs of their years together, their deep and abiding love was really truly what sustained them and got them through. I know that Richard Nixon is not necessarily seen as a great romantic, but if one reads some love letters from a young Whittier lawyer penned to Pat Ryan, who was the beautiful Whittier High School teacher he was trying to court, your view will change. Among those letters, he wrote some of these lines here. Every day and every night, I want to see you and be with you. Let's go for a long ride on Sundays. Let's go to the mountains on the weekends. Let's read books in front of fires. Most of all, let's really grow together and find the happiness we know is ours. To me, if that doesn't capture the essence of Valentine's Day, I don't know really what would. And to me, it's always fun to share this kind of romantic side of Richard Nixon with folks such as yourselves, because no one typically knows that it even existed. It is, however, known that Nixon shared a great love of our country, which they served so long and so well as proud American patriots. I know they'd be pleased by the special program tonight, and we are grateful to have the talented soldier singers of the Soldiers Chorus of the United States Army Field Band with us this morning. Excuse me, this evening. Founded in 1957, the chorus has performed in all 50 states, Canada, Mexico, India, the Far East, and throughout Europe. And tonight, we are privileged to have them right here in Yorba Linda. So please join me in welcoming to the Nixon Library the Soldiers Chorus of the United States Army Field Band.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from Washington, D.C., the Department of the Army proudly presents the Soldiers Chorus of the United States Army Field Band.
Please welcome Associate Bandmaster and Director of the Soldiers Chorus, Captain Joel Dubois.
Thank you.
pluribus unum. Out of the many, one. Just as each voice in a chorus contributes to the sound of the ensemble, each American life is a thread in the tapestry of our nation. Your United States Army is made up of individuals from all walks of life. As soldiers, we have the opportunity to unite in service to our country and its people.
There is truly no place that we would rather be this evening than right here with you. We are thrilled to be in your Belinda to celebrate America, honor our veterans, and connect with you on behalf of American soldiers.
Since the dawn of our nation, the right to raise our voices has been one of our most sacred freedoms. What better way to acknowledge our shared experiences than to come together and raise our voices in harmony? As one community with one voice, we invite you to join us as we honor our nation with the singing of our national anthem.
Our color guard this evening, Troy High School Junior ROTC.
Thank you.
Please be seated. That was a truly stunning sing-along of the national anthem. We're so grateful for you all to be here, and we think you should probably join us along on our tour. Please do listen for some more singing opportunities for yourselves later in the program. Good evening, everyone. I am Sergeant First Class Michaela Shelton, and this is Staff Sergeant James Wilson. And when we say it is our pleasure to be here in beautiful California instead of Washington, D.C. at this time of year, rest assured that we do mean it.
That's right. We are just 3 days into a 35-day concert tour that will take us from California all the way through Arizona, New Mexico, Oklahoma, and Texas. And not only is it wonderful for the Soldiers Chorus to have the opportunity to see the country, but after the last couple years of bringing virtual concerts to our online audience, seeing you here tonight is truly a joy.
Now let's continue to let freedom sing with this next selection from the distinctive American musical voice of Bobby McFerrin. This is Freedom is a Voice.
Freedom is a song. good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this concert by the Soldiers Chorus of the U.S. Army Field Band. I just want to take a moment to introduce this next piece. Surveys tell us that Americans, many Americans, don't personally know a soldier. So you may see them on TV, you may read about them in the newspaper, but few Americans really know what they do, and even fewer get a chance to understand why they serve. And so we've commissioned this next piece to pull back the curtain on the heart of the American soldier. And I'll just let you in on a little secret tonight. This is the first time this piece is being performed publicly. So you get a chance to I'd like for you to take out the insert. Most of you have an insert, if you can pull that out here. And I'd like for you to follow along to the words that are printed for the song Born for This. So these words were written at Fort Bragg, North Carolina in 2021. These words were spoken on drop zones and in homes and in community centers on base. These are the words of Specialist Dylan Cherry and Sarah Stark, the wife of Captain Zachary Stark, and Command Sergeant Major retired Thaddeus Gaweda, and many, many other voices at Fort Bragg. People just like you and me. This piece is a story about people, and it highlights three crucial points in military service. First is enlistment and basic training. And so you're going to get a chance to come to basic training tonight with us and experience some of the highs and the stresses and the uncertainties of what that experience is like for an American soldier. You'll see the graduation ceremony. You'll get to hear the graduation ceremony. But we also want to give you a glimpse into why these young people make the decision to serve their country. The second movement of the piece describes the joys and the challenges of military life and family. And you'll get a chance to glimpse what is going on even in a paratrooper's mind during an airborne jump. And lastly, the third movement is retirement and a retrospective, a look back on a career of service. And binding it all together is this theme of hail and farewell. A saying as old as the military itself. Please enjoy Born for This.
Thank you.
You've seen them on YouTube, you've seen them on Facebook. Now please enjoy this selection by our very own Who A Cappella. Since time immemorial, songs have been the soundtrack of humanity, whether in life's mundane moments or its most precious. From the lullaby that calms the newborn baby to the hymn that deepens worship, songs energize our daily work. They help us to celebrate and to mourn, and all share that common thread of bringing communities together. Thank you.
almost 250 years, your United States Army has defended our Constitution, our homeland, and our fellow Americans. At this very moment, there are over 174,000 soldiers stationed in 140 nations around the globe, and on our behalf. Whatever the mission, the resilience and strength of our American soldier remain at the heart of your United States Army.
Tomorrow all the things were gone I'd worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my family by my side. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. To be an American, where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the ones who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up against you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA. Well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say,
throughout our nation's history, everyday heroes have stood up and put the freedom and safety of others before their own. Soldiers understand that the liberty we enjoy as Americans was paid for with the sacrifices of the veterans who have gone before us. Their legacy is alive tonight, and we honor them with this next song.
Thank you.
From Thomas Jefferson, Alexander Hamilton, and George Washington, to Harriet Tubman, Abraham Lincoln, and Martin Luther King Jr., freedom meant a promise to future generations.
An ideal for which to always be striving.
A commitment to human spirit and human dignity.
Our freedoms give us the ability to dream and the opportunity to make those dreams a reality.
The promise of freedom still resonates in every human heart, and the spirit still stirs with the refrain, "Let freedom ring."
My country, it is of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing.
Land where my fathers died, land of the
its music resound throughout the nation. Oh, let it celebrate sweet liberty that is keeping us free and strong.
It's a dream.
just say this, all right? We have waited 2 years to look out here and see you tonight. And you know, we are happy to do YouTube, and we're dialed in, and we're doing Facebook, and please connect with us on those sites. But there is just nothing, like face-to-face seeing America. America, you are gorgeous. Let me just say that, all right? So happy Valentine's Day, America. So on behalf of Major General Alan Pepin, the commanding general of the Military District of Washington, as well as Colonel Jim Keane, the commander of the U.S. Army Field Band and Soldiers Chorus, and really on behalf of all the men and women of your United States Army, I just want to thank you for your warm welcome here in your Belinda. We could not do what we do as an army without your support, and we stand here, standing here tonight as soldiers on behalf of every soldier in the U.S. Army to say